Hey girl, hey, welcome back to the Slay Girl Slay podcast. Hello boo, happy Monday, what's up? I hope you guys are feeling good today, looking cute and you're moisturized and your hair looks the way you want it to and you feel beautiful and your outfit is cute and you just feel like a whole vibe today. I hope all of you had a great weekend this weekend and your Monday is off to a great start today. Whether you are at work or at home or driving somewhere or sitting in your car, I am sending you love today and all of my good vibes and wishing you an amazing week this week. I've missed you guys so much, and I'm so glad to be back for our girl chat this week. So much has been going on with me the past few weeks, you guys, and in order to keep Slay Girl Slay running, I have to keep me running and the other things running in my life as well. I was traveling for a bit. I went to San Francisco for a little while for the NPR How I Built This Summit. And girl, we will get to that in a minute. I had to move unexpectedly out of my apartment. Ugh, I was having a ton of issues with my upstairs neighbor. Listen, we will save all of that juicy goodness for another episode because, child, I have a story for you. But ended up moving and having to pack up my apartment and move unexpectedly and was all over the place for the past couple of weeks. So I appreciate your patience and appreciate you guys still tuning in. It was not my intention to be gone for the past couple of weeks, but real life happens, you guys. So appreciate you guys tuning in. Welcome back. I've missed you guys so much. If you are a member of our girl gang, you did not miss us because you got that extra podcast episode. So you go, boo. So shout out to our girl gang members. For those of you that don't know, we now have our own members only club, and that's open to anyone who wants to join. Our members get one extra podcast episode a month. So that podcast episode will not be on any of our audio platforms, but sent directly to our members. Membership is $5 a month, y'all, so be sure to click the link in our description and on our social media profiles if you want in. I can tell you now that I already have some extra things planned for the Girl Gang members, especially coming up around the holidays, that you don't want to miss. So get over there, join our Girl Gang, and do not miss out. Now, listen, as I already mentioned, I am fresh off of a trip to San Francisco for the NPR How I Built This Summit. And y'all, when I say I am completely full after leaving that conference, I am full. It was so great to be in the room with some of the world's biggest game changers in the entrepreneur space. And it was just so amazing to connect with people like me who just have a big, crazy idea that they want to see flourish. I met so many people, shook so many hands. I got thrown into the spotlight, y'all, and ended up having to get on stage and I had to pitch Slay Girl Slay to a room full of people. Ooh, I was not ready. Almost crapped myself. And y'all know a few episodes ago, your girl was scared to death to tell people about her business. So I feel like I've come full circle. But it was just an awesome, scary, wild, fulfilling opportunity that I will never forget. And I am so grateful that I was selected to be a part of it. The entire team at NPR was unbelievable, you guys, and they treated me like royalty. Every person I met knew about us, knew about Slay Girl Slay, knew about you guys. They knew about the podcast, and everyone wanted to pull me aside to talk about it. And it was just unreal. I've never experienced anything like that. And I hope you guys can hear the gratefulness I have in my heart right now. Most importantly, because I was talking about Slay Girl Slay so much and the plans that I have for this brand and the podcast and many more things that I want to create for all of you, I just felt so proud, y'all, that God gave me this baby to grow and nurture and lead. And I'm so proud that I get to talk to all of you every single week. And we have truly built this community of sisterhood amongst ourselves. If you go to the Slay Girl Slay social media pages, it is truly nothing but love in the comments and encouragement amongst each other. And we need that in our lives. And I'm so proud to be a part of Slay Girl Slay and what it's doing, and stand up in a room full of people and show them how important our community is, how relevant we are, and how we literally can be any and everything we dream ourselves up to be. So with that, I will say though, leading up to this conference and literally as soon as I learned that I was going, it felt like all hell broke loose in my life. Literally, as soon as this blessing fell into my lap, my faith started to get tested in so many areas of my life. And there were and still are days where I felt like I just wanted to pack all my stuff, hop on a plane, go back home to Chicago, get in my mama's bed and cry, to be honest. You guys have known about NPR for about a month now, I'll say, but I've known for months. And ever since I got that message letting me know that I was selected to be a 2019 fellow, all of a sudden, things just started to go haywire, and I'm having issues with my apartment and my neighbors. I'm having issues with my finances. I'm having issues with my relationships, and I've been just really seeing how resilient I am and just how powerful resilience can be. We are all going through something. I don't care if you have $1 million in the bank. I don't care if you are at the perfect job. I don't care if you have a business, whatever. We are all going through something. And I know you guys can agree. But what keeps us going and what keeps us getting up and going to work and what keeps us from giving up and backing down and falling apart is our resilience, our ability to bounce back, our ability to get back up and dust ourselves off no matter how hard we get knocked down. I know some days it really feels like someone has two hands on your shoulders and they are physically throwing you to the ground, and it hurts because that's how it feels, because you feel like you're doing everything you can to be everything you want to be. Why is this happening? You're thinking, why do things keep happening to me? What is going on? And as I'm getting older, I'm learning more and more that no matter how sweet life can be, there will always be something that you need to overcome. And the way to continuously overcome and to bounce back and to keep getting up is resilience. Resilience is the process of adapting well in the face of adversity, trauma, tragedy, or significant amounts of stress. You can experience any of these within your families, your health, a family member's health, workplace stress, financial stress. And resilience is being able to adapt to these experiences. Let me tell you about adaptability. Adaptability is the quality of being able to adjust to new conditions, the capacity to modify yourself, to continue to move through your surroundings. Of course, this is news to me, right? So I'm doing some digging, and for the sake of not giving you guys a science lesson, in short, humans are the most adaptive species on this planet. We adapt to the climate. We adapt to our environment. Our bodies adapt when we have babies. We are naturally hardwired to adapt to the changes around us. And you're like, Ash, my world is falling apart right now. I have a lot going on. I hear you, boo, but my answer to you is that you will not die. Whatever it is that's going on, you may be getting stretched right now. You may be getting bent in every which way. But you will not break. You have resilience within you that you just need to tap into a little more and realize that whatever it is that's going on, you will not break. Resilience is not some characteristic trait that people either have or they don't have, right? But it involves behaviors and thoughts and most of all, actions that you learn and develop over time. Resilience is a skill, boo. Being resilient is a skill built only through hardship. And here's the thing, sis, you can't change the fact that super stressful things will happen, right? You can't change the fact that no matter how good life may be going, or no matter how much money you're making, or how much little John John may love you, that stressful things will happen. But what you can change is how you respond to it. This was a big lesson for me, especially over the last few months. I am quick to respond to stress. And when crappy things happen, I instantly adopt this mindset that things are happening to me instead of for me. And so my reaction is that of fear or anger or sadness. I have this, you know, woe is me attitude. And I'm thinking, why is this happening to me? Instead of praying and asking God, Lord, what are you trying to teach me? And you have my attention. What do you need from me? To be honest, this is what my prayer sounds like. Lord, now I'm doing everything you asked me to do. I'm not hoeing out here in these streets. I only have wine with dinner. Sometimes if I'm feeling social, I might have two. I'm nice to everyone, or at least I try to be. I gave a dollar to the homeless man on the street today. I'm still single, even though I can probably date any guy that will ask me. I'm not scamming people for money. What more do you want from me? I'm just being honest. Don't hate me. But man, have I learned that it's not about what's happening in my life, but it's about my response. Will I continue to get up and be the woman I want to be, regardless of my circumstances, regardless of how hard it may be right now? Will I continue to encourage people and motivate people, even though people hurt me and are doing things to make me fail? What's your response, boo? What has helped me in tapping into my resilience? And when it feels like everything is falling apart around me, I try to keep my perspective. I allow myself to feel the sad and to feel the anger and to feel that chip on my shoulder, right? But after a while, you have to wipe your face. You have to come down from that anger and put things into perspective. I always say this, look around. Last year, did you think you would be where you are today? 2 years ago, would you be sitting in the spot that you're sitting in right now? Look around. Some of the things you are actually looking at, you prayed and cried for. Some of the things that you see every single day were once prayers and dreams you wanted so badly. Pick up the phone. Call your family. Did they pick up? If they did, they're alive. They're breathing. They're still here. When you go home tonight, look around. You have a door. I walked past a man today that lived in a cardboard box on Sunset Boulevard. You have a door, boo, a bathroom, a bed, a television. And if you're like me, a Netflix, a Hulu, Amazon Prime, food in the fridge, a stove that cooks food, water running through the faucet, who cares if money is short? You are here today. And I'm not saying that to be hard on you. I'm saying that because that's the perspective I had to take a step back and consider for myself. Maybe being resilient is about being patient. I know we want things to work out now, and we want things to work out right now, today, the way we want them to, but things don't happen on our time, y'all. Things don't change and work out when we want them to. So we have to be resilient and practice patience, change our perspective, and control what we can control. And the rest, we must let go. Think about your situation and ask yourself, what can I control? I sometimes hate telling my mom about a problem that I'm having because her response is always, well, what can you control? And I'm like, girl, did you just hear what I said? I said this girl did this, 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 and she made me feel this, 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 and so now I got to do this. And she's like, I heard you, but what can you control? And it's frustrating because it's a big pill to swallow, boo. Think about what can you physically control? What can you truly do to make your situation better? And when you have that in mind, act on it. Do it. You've already cried about it. You may cry a little more later today. That's okay. You may cry a little more later next week. Who knows? You've already been mad and sad about it. Now you just have to do what you can do, and that's it. You can only do what you can do. You can only focus on what you can control. And what you can't control, you can't focus on. What's a podcast episode without a scripture? Stand with me and turn with me in your Bibles to Jeremiah chapter 29:11. I'm kidding. But y'all know your girl can quote a scripture too. And this scripture has popped up so many times on this podcast, but one I keep near and dear to my heart. It is Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not on your own understanding. But in all your ways, acknowledge him and he will make your paths straight. Another one, Romans 8:37, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. So accept this challenge, boo. It is making you greater. It's making you stronger. It is preparing you for whatever it is that's on the other side of this battle. So gear up, wipe your face. Go into work today with a smile. Know that you are more than a conqueror, boo. Tell whatever battle that's in front of you that they must not know who you are, that they must not know what your future is looking like. They must not know how far you've already come. Because when you build that skill of being resilient, when things happen in the future, you get better at responding to them, big or small, right? For instance, you apply to a job and you get rejected the first time. Your feelings are hurt. You're mad. You're frustrated. You do it again. You apply to 10 jobs and get rejected. It's frustrating, but your feelings aren't hurt anymore and you've adapted to it. You keep hitting that wall. Eventually, it will crack. Eventually, it will break. Being resilient will get you far, boo. Resilience is trying to get into a program at school and getting denied over and over and over again, but having the courage to apply one more time only to get accepted. Resilience is trying to get that house you want and getting rejected over and over again, and you try one more time to only get that house, to get that car, that book deal, that apartment, that program, that job. You see where I'm going? Whatever it is that's happening right now in your life may be tough, but you're learning how to be resilient. And that resilience is what will keep you fighting in the future for your dreams. Don't back down, boo. Get up, shake it off. If you get pushed again, get back up, push back. It doesn't matter if you're broke and trying to figure out how you're going to eat this week. Spaghetti will last all week. Next, it doesn't matter if your car is acting stupid and you can't get to work. Thankfully, we live in a world where Uber and Lyft exist. And if that's not it, there is a bus and a train with your name on it. Next, it doesn't matter if you hate where you work and the people you work with, but guess what? It paid the bills right now until you can get to the job that you love. What's next? It sucks. I know. And it's not ideal. It's not how we want to feel right now. It doesn't feel great. I know. I'm in the same boat, boo. But you have to keep going. You have to keep pushing. You have to keep striving for greatness, regardless of what you may have going on in your life right now. This message was a message for me as well. And I needed this because I too am getting stretched. And there are days when I feel like I'm getting pushed and bent into every which way. But sis, you will survive the stretch. You will get back up after being pushed. You will bend, but you most certainly will not break. All right. right, my loves, that wraps us up for this week. I would much appreciate it if you guys would leave a comment in the comment section with your thoughts on the Slay Girl Slay podcast, and even more if you would subscribe. Send me an email with any topics or feedback on today's podcast, and you can always find us on Instagram and Facebook at Slay Girl Slay, or come visit us on our website at www.slaygirlslay.com. Until next week, we will chat soon, boo. Peace.